In this video, I'm going to show you how to find and fix technical SEO issues with your website. If you're not very tech savvy like me, you can find it hard to find these technical SEO issues, which may be impacting your rankings. And that's where an SEO audit tool comes in handy. Otherwise, you have to literally manually look at your site and hope that you discover technical SEO issues, or go through Google Search Console and hope that Google tells you what the errors are and how to fix them. And they don't always do that. In fact, just this week, I found a number of technical SEO issues on my site that I didn't know about and I plan on fixing. Now, it's hard to say whether those issues are impacting my rankings in any way, but either way, they're good to clean up and stay on top of. In fact, I would say in many ways, technical SEO is the foundation of SEO, because if you don't get that right, it can sometimes be hard to rank in the first place. And even if you are ranking well, staying on top of technical SEO and making sure errors are discovered and fixed is just important maintenance for your site overall. With that, let's get right into the exact steps. So your first step is to run a site audit on one of the sites that you have a project for in Semrush. And this will basically send a crawler from Semrush to crawl your website, similar to how Google does, and it'll figure out any issues or errors that you're having and generate a report. And this is the overview that you'll see. In this video, it's really focused on prioritizing which things to work on, because if you haven't really stayed on top of your technical SEO, you might find that you have a lot of these warnings and notices, and it can be honestly kind of scary when you see them, because you're like, I have 3,200 notices and 1,900 warnings, and I'm not tech savvy, how do I do this? Well, fortunately, when it comes to technical SEO, you really want to focus on the big issues that might be impacting crawling specifically, or indexing, where Google can't even index some of your pages that you want in the first place. And if they can't do that, it has no chance of ranking. And that's going to be in the errors category. Warnings are more things to keep an eye on, and notices are things that aren't as important. And the good news is, even if you see some big numbers here, typically it's the same error happening across multiple pages. It's not like you have 1,900 things on your to-do list all of a sudden. It's more that you probably have 5 or 10 things that are impacting a lot of pages, and that's why there's so many warnings. But they're still worth keeping an eye on, even if there's warnings and notices. But you definitely want to zero in on the error side of things, because if you don't, then it can be easy to get sort of lost in the weeds with things like internal linking, which is important for ranking, but it's not really something that's going to make or break your technical SEO. It's not really, something that if you don't do internal linking right, your site's going to get de-indexed or something. Versus technical SEO, that can definitely happen. So what you want to do is head over to the issues tab in Semrush, and this will show you the things that are the biggest high priority things to work on first. And if you don't know how to fix these things, I would recommend hiring a developer and or an SEO expert to help you with this. So let's look at some of the errors that I'm finding here, just as sort of an example to look at. So 25 incorrect pages found in the sitemap. Why and how to fix it. What you want to do is click on this, and it'll give you a little bit of an overview of what's going on. And basically, in this case, there are pages in the sitemap that shouldn't be there. They're either redirected or 404ing or whatever. And there's a page in the sitemap that's telling Google, I want these pages indexed. And if the page is redirecting to another page or not, doesn't exist anymore, then it shouldn't be in the sitemap together. And this is something that you want to fix. And it shows you how to fix it here. But again, if you're not tech savvy, you'll need someone that can actually go into your sitemap and fix it for you. So this issue with duplicate title tags is usually a bit more concerning, in my opinion, because this shows you have multiple pages on your website that are usually have the same content. Typically, if the title tag is exactly the same, the content is exactly the same. So again, you want to click on this and understand, like I mentioned, the crawler only reports duplicate if it's exactly the same. If there's one word different, it won't show up here. So typically when you see this, it means the pages themselves are exactly the same. Now, in this case, it's just pagination, which isn't a huge deal, but if you want, you could always just, no index these pagination pages, or use a canonical tag to say all of these blog pages are the same as this one. But again, you'll want someone technical to deal with this stuff, because this canonical tags can go wrong. No index can go really wrong. In this case, I probably wouldn't sweat it, even though this could be a problem. In this case, it's not. And that's why it's important to actually look at the error that you're seeing and investigate what's happening. Because if these are 4 different service pages or blog posts or product pages that were exactly the same, that'd be something I'd want to fix ASAP. So let's go back to the issues, and we'll go down to the warning section, and I'll show you some things about this. So 1,127 issues with unminified JavaScript and CSS files. This can basically slow down your website and make it, slower to load, which is bad for user experience and also not great for SEO. But again, if you click on this, it's typically the same problem just happening across multiple different pages. So if you fix this once with a developer, it's usually going to fix all 1,127 of these issues. I think Semrush does a good job of prioritizing which ones to focus on, like errors like sitemap issues, duplicate title tags, duplicate meta descriptions. That's not ideal, but I wouldn't sweat it too much, but still something to pay attention to. Or if you see pages that don't have title tags or duplicate content issues, pages that can't be crawled, this is where you really want to jump in and fix them. Fortunately, I'm not having this issue with Backlinko, but it's something to keep an eye on. Warnings are a little bit lower priority, but still usually worth fixing. Like for example, 426 images on the site don't have alt text. That's something that can just be fixed. It's probably not killing the page's SEO or not allowing the image to rank in Google Images, but it's definitely not helping. And it's just something that, you probably want to stay on top of. When you get down to notices, those are things that are really, you can just wait on. Outgoing external links contain nofollow attributes. That's something you might want to have. In the case of Backlinko, they're likely blog comments that I didn't have a nofollow on, so that's why they have nofollow attributes, which is no big deal. Or links that have no anchor text. Maybe that's on purpose. Maybe that's because, I just wanted a raw link there. Or let's say 94 URLs have a permanent redirect. Maybe I want that there. That's what three-run redirects are. They're permanent redirects. So there's probably sometimes a reason to have this. So again, notices are more notices. They're just like, hey, keep an eye on this. Maybe you want this, maybe you don't, but either way, you should be notified of it. So let's look at a couple more reports from the site audit feature to help you prioritize where to start. So this is really cool, and this is something that I haven't seen in too many other tools. So instead of just showing you the issues, this will actually show you the pages that are having, the most issues. And this can help you identify where to start first. One way is to go to issues and focus on errors and warnings, but you can also look at which pages are causing the most issues. And in this case, this page from SEO, about SEO training has more issues than some of these hub pages. And the reason for that is because in this case, this is a custom page that has a bunch of custom stuff going on. And it's probably not as optimized as it could be when it comes to technical SEO. It also doesn't share a lot of the same HTML and formatting that the other pages have that are optimized. So for example, if I went back and was to improve some of these other pages, it wouldn't affect this SEO training page because it's sort of separate. And a lot of websites have that. They have a couple pages that are like these custom sort of pages and they're sort of separate and they don't get looked at for a while. And this can be helpful for identifying which issues to keep an eye on first. So once you started to fix these issues, the next step is to monitor your stats and see how things are improving over time. And actually, you can do that in Semrush using this compare crawls feature. So if you're going in and you're like, I want to get my technical SEO under control, let me go in and fix all this stuff, you can see if it's making a difference or not. Ideally, you want these fixed numbers to be going up and these new numbers to be going down because you're fixing these issues. And this can help you track your progress over time and even get down to the specific issue that you're seeing and seeing whether it's actually fixed. Because if you make a change with your HTML and someone says, all right, it's done, it's fixed, it might be or it might not, because there could be some other issue that it developed by fixing it, which can happen sometimes, or sometimes the issue looks fixed, but it's not really. So you'll want to wait for your next crawl or rerun a crawl, and that way you can see if these errors are actually being fixed and monitor them over time. So in the case of 75 issues fixed and 61 new, that's sometimes a case of the fix causing more issues, or just sometimes it's random. And in this case, that's what it is. It's random. Or total warnings, total errors, and total notices. This is the real number that you really want to focus on, where you want this to be lower over time and you want warnings to be lower and notices can be more or less the same. Because again, notices are sometimes things you want to fix or sometimes things that you want there, like a redirect. So that's how to find and prioritize fixing critical errors on your website.